strength is a big portion in regards to your butt, your glutes, your quads, your hamstrings. Most of the time, what a top sprinter is gonna have, we're gonna be fairly similar. We're gonna be stronger than a top sprinter is because we're pushing something that weighs a lot. And so generally we're gonna be bigger, and we're gonna be bigger all over. So the power will come up through your feet, come up through your legs, you know, your legs and your glutes are gonna maximize. You also have to have a strong upper body to stabilize yourself when you're pushing. Your core, your back, that all has to be extremely strong to continue that chain to actually apply the force. Physically, can they, you know, clean a lot? Can they squat a lot? Can they deadlift and or bench a lot? Yes. But they're also going to be able to sprint extremely fast and utilize that. Usually they can jump extremely far as well. None of us have cardio whatsoever. If we do, we're going to train it earlier in the summer, and it's going to be 100 meter stuff. But everybody and every bobsledder is going to be extremely powerful and fast and explosive from 0 to 30 or 40 meters, and that's it. An average girl is going to be about 5'6", 5'7", ideally. They're going to have long femurs. Everyone should have long femurs. They're going to be 165 to 170 pounds. That's going to be your ideal height-weight ratio. The men's side, Kevin Kuska, for years on the German program, he's probably one that you would look at and go, okay, that's a specimen. That's exactly what you'd want all your brakemen to be like. Overall, yes, the guys are going to be roughly 6'4". They're going to weigh 230 to 240 pounds. That's going to be your top guys. It takes a special person to do this sport, for sure. It does not feel like a roller coaster whatsoever. It's a completely different feeling. At no point do you get that stomach coming up in your throat feeling. The pressure, the G-force, all of that is a different experience. I would say a lot of people that come out do not like the ride. You get used to it. You enjoy it by the end, but it's not something that most people go into and go, this is sweet. Very rare. We are slightly nuts, and most people would soon so. This is a dangerous sport. You gotta understand that this sport does take a toll. It does beat you around, you know, and mentally it's very, very hard. You have to be mentally very tough, and physically it's a lot of humping and dumping of sleds. It's a lot of moving and a lot of, you know, getting beat by fiberglass and steel. So you end up with bruises, but at the end of the day, are you more badass and tough for it? Definitely, and I think that's where we all slightly get our craziness from.